Today's rainfall simulator really drove home the four principles of soil health. Number one, keeping that soil covered, whether that's with residue or cover crops. Number two, having a living cover going through the winter, so we can keep that biology going as long as possible. Also, anytime, the third principle is we can get more diversity into the mix. The more diverse, the better opportunity that we have to feed that soil health. And then the final one, and is absolutely very important, is to not disturbing that soil profile. So reducing the tillage, and even better yet, eliminating the tillage out there and allowing that structure to develop in the soil. It's going to increase the infiltration and also allow the soils to warm up as well. Presented here is a conventional till. This field has been continuously tilled with corn silage for the last couple of years. Really has very little structure to it and very little residue. The second one is more of it's a farm that's transitioning to less tillage. They're using some no-tills. They're also embracing the reduced till. But they're really spending a lot of time and a lot of effort on getting that cover crop established as soon as possible. The middle soil is a soil off of a dairy also. It's been no-till for 5-6 years, and it was corn silage this year and now has some covers that were established in it just a week or so ago. The fourth one here is a transition into a no-till dairy system. So Dan is standing over here, so that piece comes off of Dan Bricks. It's a 10-way mix of cover crops. I purposely avoided the sunflowers and a lot of the other species just because it was going to interfere with the rain, but it is a pretty good representative sample of what's in that field. So there's some oats, some triticale, hairy vetch, some radish, primarily in that one. And the last one is off a rotational grazing farm. It's been seeded down since 2013, so this is its third year. And before that, it was in a corn bean conventional till system. So what we're going to do is we're going to start up the rainfall. So just to tell you a little bit more about this simulator, the front row of buckets is what we're trying to show is the runoff that's going to be coming off of these plots. The buckets behind it are actually, there's pans underneath these five representative samples, so it's going to show infiltration, okay? So each of these samples we're taking by putting a form into the ground, pounding it in, and then we cut around it all the way, and we lift that out intact, okay? It's a little bit more complicated with the conventional till. That's a little bit different process to get that one in there. But what this is showing is the primary aspects of soil health, okay? One of the biggest ones is we want to keep that ground covered, okay? And you're seeing that on the three that have really really good covers. The other important aspect of soil health, and we've hit on it a couple times this morning, is trying to keep something growing and living through the winter. So we want to try and keep that biology going throughout the winter and also to be ready there next spring to also take off. It's probably the biggest one that is shown here is the aspect of tillage and not disturbing that soil. I like Brent's analogy a lot about bulldozing the house down and the structure, and that is it's so true. That far sample basically has no structure to it at all. It has the bucket in the back has close to zero infiltration going through it because there's no macro pores at all. Whereas when you get to these two samples here on the end, And even the second one, when I was cutting those out of the ground and shaving them on the bottom to fit in there, there was a lot of killing going on, okay? There was a lot of earthworms that perished in the middle, or in the aspect of, or in the process of getting this in, because those soils are just loaded with earthworms. So, you see the infiltration rates on the greener covers also. So with those, all those macropores and all that structure, there's actually just as much more water going through the soil than is running off. So think of how that affects water quality on a larger scale. Whether it's the Plum, whether it's the Fox River. If we can get that water, the meltwater, the rainwater, to soak into the ground instead of running off, this is showing you a really good representation of how that water can be held. It was 8/10. So that's what that gives you an idea of what we would like to think is a typical rain. Maybe not this year, since we get 2 and 3 inches at a crack, it seems like this year. But you can hear the water. It's just basically running through all those pores. The story with this one in the middle, I want to talk about just the importance of trying to get the covers established as soon as possible after corn silage is taken off, okay? So this field right here was seeded about a day, or the same day that the silage was taken off. It was seeded with a piece of tillage equipment and an air box, much like the one that we looked at this morning. Well, the same kind of box. Produces a really, really nice carpet of cover out there that is primarily winter rye. This cover right here is a mixture, and with a couple more weeks of heat, we're actually going to get more growth out of that too. So that field is going to end up looking really nice yet this fall too. But the more growth that we can get going into the winter and have for next spring, the better. When we start talking about soluble nutrients and moving through the systems, what we have to remember is, just in a straight no-till, we're going to get water moving through macropores. But the whole story is, we have to get the living roots to also be growing, to be part of that. So you have the no-till and you have the cover crop, so you can be taking up some of those nutrients. In our deep clay soils here, you know, we don't have a lot of concerns. I guess what I'd like to really concentrate on is the difference in color of water compared to the front, which, I don't know what you want to call it, chocolate milk, compared to more of a tea water, I guess would be a way of saying it. So that is pretty darn good filtered water for going through. Some other take-home points from this, and we saw it this morning between the two fields, the one that was no-till and the one that was more of a conventional till. I mean, just putting your hand in here, can you imagine like driving across this? This is gonna rut up compared to the structure that you have on a field that's been in cover crops, okay? The other thing that I think this shows really well is, sometimes folks think, well, erosion, okay, well that has to be this gully or this little rill that comes off the field. That's carrying all of our sediment. There's no rill here. I mean, this is the true sense of just sheet and rill erosion about what's coming off that field. So it hammers home the point, in my opinion, of the need for covers and structure.